Hey guys, in this video we're going to be talking about bowing. So especially if you're a brand new student or a current student that just wants to refresh your protocol, this is the video for you. When you're bowing, come from musubidachi, heels together, toes apart, hands are fingers together, flat against your legs, make sure that it's secure, not hanging. And when you bow, take your time, come to about a 45 degree angle and back up. Be respectful and courteous on these bows, take your time with them. Try not to come all the way down. You don't want to lose that zanshin or that awareness around you, so don't lose sight of what's going on around you. When you're in seiza, go down to seiza. Again, the same idea. This is for bow-ins for class. Try not to put your head on the floor. That's a little bit too low. So come again to about a 45 degree angle and back up. Shorin Kalunga will go over the details of when and where to bow in the dojo.
Hey guys, so as Senpai Scott mentioned, technique of bowing is very important. But what's also important is when to and where to bow. The first place you should be bowing is as soon as you enter the building. The reason you're bowing as soon as you're entering the building is to prepare you to be in the correct mindset for training. The second bow is as soon as you walk onto the floor. Again, that is just to reinforce the preparation for training. Next few bows are going to be as soon as you put on your belt. There should be one from standing, one from kneeling. Put your belt on, bow, stand up, and bow again. A few other times that you should be bowing are when you see an instructor, and especially a sensei. Make sure you are courteous with your bow. Do not be rushed. Be in a proper kyotsuke, mitsubirachi. Bow, wait for them to bow also, then you may come up.